Any more speed? There we go. Another tie.
Way to handle those ties.
Get him, get him. You're on him. Gotcha. Hey, we're getting it now. Hello, ladies and gentlemen. Captain Shaq here, and welcome to X-Wing Alliance. Now, this is not the vanilla game from 1999, if you can't tell. This is heavily modified. I'll put a link in the description below. The mods actually aren't so bad to install. We'll talk about that a little bit later as we take off from our family's home base here and head off for our very first lesson. Now, I have played all the way through the first chapter getting ready for Star Wars Squadrons to come out. I'm actually really excited for it. One of the things that they added to this, by the way, you can see that on screen right now, is me trying to grab this cargo container. This was added in this version of the X-Wing series. This one actually had quite a few upgrades and a few downgrades, like as you see the HUD here. Not all, because we're using mods for this, not all of the ships have this kind of floating HUD. The X-Wings and the TIE Fighters and a few others actually have their HUD elements incorporated into the 3D cockpits, which is really cool. You probably saw that at the beginning. I'm sure I'll put an intro for like the battle, but our mission today is to do our first flight. We've been in the simulator for a while now. We're getting a handle on the controls, and our family, a group of neutral, I'll say traitors. They're not really smugglers. They are neutral and they're law abiding, are just trying to make it. And it's tough. This is the middle of the Galactic Civil War.
I bet one of us could be the next Luke Skywalker.
Who?
You know, the guy in the bootleg Holo insurance. The guy who took out the Death Star in Yavin.
Well, I hate to rain on your parade, MK.
As you probably heard, the Death Star, if I played that audio, the Death Star has been destroyed. Luke Skywalker is kind of this folk hero. And we are... the family is sympathetic to the rebels and the rebel cause. But not really willing to join, at least not all of them. One of the ways you get between missions, I actually quite like this, reminds me of Free Space 2 a bit, is how you'd come to a point and then you can jump to hyperspace around these nav beacons. And so you can have multiple areas that you'll fight through.
Hello, Azimuth Transports. Thanks for the quick service. Please deliver the cargo canisters to the docking platform.
Just watch where Silu drops her canister, then do the same. For delivery, you must engage the auto-docking procedure.
Or following the story through. And the story so far is pretty cool. It's cool to see a neutral perspective. Our mission is quite simple. Head to the station, bring the supplies, some coolant, and some fuel. But of course, it can't be that simple. That would be really boring. So we have our first run-in with the family rivals, the Varaxos. The Varaxos are either a family or a crime organization. I think they're a crime organization that is kind of up against... the family business, the Azimuths. They show up here, and you even hear the station agent being like, "Hey, our sector security forces have just bugged out. They must have been bribed. I bet you could chase these guys off. They're not expecting a fight."
Incoming vessels are on an attack vector.
It looks like these newcomers mean trouble.
System patrol craft Cord is abandoning us. They must have been bought off. Azimuth Transport, we request your assistance.
Harlequin Station, what can we do?
These Varaxo have been threatening us for a while. I didn't think they had the guts to try something like this. I am sure they were not expecting a fight. If you move to intercept, they'll probably back off.
They have activated their weapon targeting systems.
I'm not sure we should get involved.
I say we fight. We can run rings around any Varaxo pilot.
Dad's been trying to reach an understanding with the Varaxo.
Someone needs to tell the Varaxo that. They are attacking us.
All right, I'm convinced. Let's teach them some manners.
What do you Azimuth fools think you're doing? This is a private matter you do well to stay out of.
Well, we're involved now. I'd back off if I were you.
And sure enough, I fly out there. And this is kind of an issue with a lot of missions. I fly out there, you fire at them a few times, and the dialogue is like, "That'll teach them." You don't really blow them up, you just chase them off. But they don't leave. And my first time playing through this is like, well, okay, the dialogue said that that'll teach them, they've run, don't kill them, there's no need. You know, we're not here to just blow these guys out of the water. But the mission didn't end, and I found myself just floating around. I had to shoot them a few more times to trigger the end of the mission. So if you're gonna play this, of all the links to the mods will be in the description, don't feel bad to pull up a guide if you need to, because there's a lot of that, like, you're expected to do a certain thing at certain times that the dialogue doesn't really support, and the mission objectives doesn't really spell out. And you might get stuck. This is one of those instances where all I had to do was just shoot the guy a few times. Now, of course, the Vazarios or Vraxos, actually Vraxos, that's how you say it. The Vraxos are not just going to piss off. I am using, later you'll see a bit more actually functioning. It wasn't in the first mission, head tracking in this, and it works wonderfully. Also, it has VR support now as of like August, which is amazing that this is still getting modded. Up to, I would say it's got the graphics levels of like something out of maybe mid-2000s, like 2008 maybe? Might be stretching it a bit, 2009. I think it looks great though, especially for a game from 1999, which is absolutely incredible. So the second mission that they send us on is Amon's Lesson. And it's all about weaponry. And of course, the guy teaching us about weapons is flying a fire spray. This is the class of ship that Boba Fett uses. And it's one of the cooler ships in Star Wars. We get a nice good look at it with an upgraded model. As I said, we talk about mods later. Well, we're using a ton of replacers for the starships that we're flying around. Now, this mission takes place from a new perspective. We're not flying. Our droid counterpart is, who is probably the most gung-ho character in the entire series. He is ready to be the hero the Rebellion needs, which is a pretty fantastic. But this mission, when you play it, it's kind of a slog, and you're only in the turret, and you don't have control over the ship. And we actually got stuck during the stream where my pilot, my droid companion, we're supposed to be shooting the random trash that this ship drops. You can see him right now on screen. He's going to be dropping off little probes that we can fire at, and eventually we're going to have to just go into a sector and shoot at some random debris to get comfortable with the controls that we will never use again because they're, you know, it's the turret, and the turret has an auto-fire mode, which is amazing, but they don't teach you how to use that in this mission.
Okay, just keep her studying through the jump part.
Yes, sir. Permission to take evasive maneuvers if necessary?
Denied. Soak your gun and don't blast anything threatening.
Splendid! I have total confidence in his ability.
Wonderful. Now if your pipe dying, we'll proceed.
So anyways, you get stuck, the pilot actually stopped, and I was not in an angle where I could shoot any of the targets, we just stood there. The way to fix this is actually use your arrow keys and go into the comm system and order your allies to attack, meaning they'll actually do the job for you. Amon's Slave One there, or Fire Spray, excuse me, Slave One is a specific ship. Amon's Fire Spray will run around and actually start taking out the targets for you, and then eventually the YT that you're in, the 1300, will start moving. Now, this isn't Han Solo's YT, right? This isn't his Corellian freighter, so this only has the standard one turret on the top instead of having the twin guns on it, which is, you know, it'd be cool, and you'd actually be able to hit everything. The whole time we were doing this, we were playing this mission on stream, I was sitting here going, man, I kind of miss Star Wars Galaxies, because this is kind of the perspective from that game. And this came out before that, I'm pretty sure. So, with our weapons training finished up, we head on back to the barn and prep for our next mission. Well, sort of. Our next mission was going to be with Aaron, but there's been an accident. There's been a data loss, and we've got to rescan all of the cargo that the family is moving. So you get a kind of a sense of what their business is, and it's a shipping business. They actually have storage containers, storage fields out in the middle of nowhere at a series of coordinates where they store stuff for people and they store their cargo containers.
I'll take the Type G's, you take the Type I's. Emon says you did pretty well with the weapons training. That's great, because things have been heating up out here since the Rebels destroyed the Empire's Death Star at Yavin. In the chaos of war, some people are sure to take advantage. As a case in point, our competition with the Viraxo. That incident at Harlequin Station is just the beginning. Yeah, Uncle Anton says Carmen Viraxo is some sort of petty crime lord, and that he's been trying to steal business from us. There's even a rumor that he's blackmailed an Imperial officer. We're going to have to be very careful out here.
Uh-oh. A
Looks like we have raiders attempting to steal from us. Primary target update. They have started their docking operation. We should make sure they do not come back.
Turns out somebody's figured out where we store our stuff, legal equipment, mostly generators and construction supplies and whatnot, which you can actually see when you lock onto boxes and scan things, which I think is quite cool. So we're sitting here trying to recover the data that our sister has managed to botch before the family, before the dad gets back. And on one of the sites that we go scan, we find no one other than the Viraxos trying to plant spice. And they actually happened to do it. They left a cargo container of spice. We respond quickly and engage in our first dogfights, which were fairly epic and kind of fun after flying through a bunch of boxes. And we're getting, the whole time we're getting this like family story, which I quite dig.
Yeah, and you realize this storage area has been compromised.
That means we will have to move all these containers.
Let's hurry up and finish, then we'll return home. Okay, we're done. Let's go home.
Should we leave that container of spice here?
I guess we ought to bring it home with us. I'll pick it up. All we need now is to get caught by a random Imperial patrol.
So what are we going to do with this spice? Well, in the next mission, we find out.
You should not have provoked them. Despite what your father thinks, the Viraxo cannot be trusted. Clearly the Viraxo are trying to get back at us in their typical underhanded way. By planting contraband at one of our facilities, they hope to see the Empire seize our assets and put us out of business. Fortunately, I have come up with a plan that will turn the tables on them and beat them at their own game.
A cargo delivery mission to sneak the spice onto the Viraxo station, one of their operating bases, so that the Empire finds it and shuts them down. So we're trying to use the Empire against them just like they were going to do to us. It's a little bit of a convoluted objective, and I love that it's actually played that way on purpose, because in the very next mission, if you, once you've managed to botch this mission, even if you complete it, it doesn't go quite to plan, your father berates you for taking such chances. So it's pretty great, because that mission specifically is a little bit weird. You need to destroy a series of defending ships. So the plan is drop the spice off, and then you and your uncle show up to back up your sister. You've got two YTs, the one you're in, the one your sister is in, who's dropping the supplies, and she's got false identification running right now. So they think she's working for them. And then you've got the fire spray that's backing you up. And your job is to go do enough damage that it causes a ruckus and gets the Empire to show up. Hopefully, after your sister has dropped the spice cargo and run off. And if you stick around too long, an ISD actually does show up. It does launch fighters, and they will try to intercept you before the mission is over, which I find that really cool. You're supposed to be long gone by then. Now, if you're going to complete the mission, it says do a certain amount of damage, and I thought that was just fight the fighters that are flying around. That's not really the case. You're going to want to fly into where the station is and attack it. Destroy some cargo containers, break some of their freighters, whatever is over there, to get that percentage of asset damage that you need to complete the objective of the mission. And then on the way out, as you're making your way out, the other freighter your sister is in is badly damaged and has to be abandoned. But if they find the ship, they'll know it was you and your family who did it. So on the way out, don't forget to destroy that freighter. So your family is out a YT. Luckily, no one's harmed if you manage to get through it. No one is harmed, and if you manage to escape and blow up the YT, they hopefully don't know it was you. And the Empire does show up. And that's the end of that mission. I actually quite like that one. There's a goofy bit where your companion, your co-pilot, is going to constantly warn you, hey, you're firing at a friendly ship, you're firing at a friendly ship, and you'll even lose score for blowing up the friendly ship. I don't know if this is a mod conflict or what, but it's actually the objective. So yeah, you're going to lose score for it, but it must be done to get through the mission and successfully complete it.
You pulled it off! I'm amazed! Well, it was a good plan, wasn't it?
Our time is up! We have to go now!
Okay, so things didn't work out exactly the way we had planned. But all things considered, I think we were successful. The Viraxa will have a very hard time convincing the Imperial authorities that they knew nothing about that contraband. At the least, it will cost them a huge amount in fines and bribes to clear it all up. If we're lucky, they'll be put out of business. The loss of the Sealu would be an insignificant price to pay for that. I can't wait to see the expression on Tomas's face when we tell him the story. He'll be very proud of you.
That is a nice souvenir you picked up in the last mission.
So just like the classic dogfighters from the 90s, obviously this is one of them, so if you've ever played like Free Space, you'll know what I'm talking about. You get these in-between mission little briefings and bits of character and lore. You actually have your email that you can check when you're back in your bunk, and this expands when you get farther into the campaign. We're almost through what I would consider the tutorial chapters and into the proper campaign, but this is a good set piece to get you started. Now, you do get little rewards that decorate your bunk, more or less. So all the little things that you see around here from the missions that we completed so far, the clan banner up there and the casino chit saved from the raiders, which was just the Veraxos. Now, the next mission is where things start getting interesting. The sixth mission in this mission-like set, this chapter. And that would be our rendezvous with the Rebel Alliance.
I've gone over the details with MK, and he'll fill you in.
Tomas and Galen are using a Gallo-3 Yards medium transport, Namasutra, to pick up a supply of Bacta on the black market. You and I, Aaron and Iman, will all go along for backup. You and I will fly the Sapper, Iman the Andrasta, and Aaron the Otana. Your father's Corellian YT-2000 transport, the Otana, is a beauty of a ship that I would love to fly. We will be meeting our contact with the smugglers at Saruan Station. The contact will give us the final coordinates for the cargo transfer.
And with that, we launch from the station, head over to our beacon, and jump to hyperspace on our way to a smuggler's station. Now we're getting into a proper Star Wars story, where we're meeting up at a smuggler's station to buy some Bacta to help, supply the Rebel Alliance, who is trying to recover from the Battle of Hoth. As we're making our way through, we're going to need a big transport, and we've got a GR-75 that's going to be going with us. We're going to be escorting it with our father in command, and we're taking his old ship out. It's all quite cool, actually. When we arrive on the station, and you'll notice, you probably recognize some of the stations and a lot of the ships from various mods that have taken them from this series. Who have been at least inspired by the series to model them out. For just a quick there, that was the map screen that I haven't used too much in this. It does play a key role in later missions, so you can see what the battle looks like. Because that's kind of one of the coolest things about this. And this is true for any of the old, like, 90s era dogfighter, space dogfighter games, is that it is a very linear experience to a point until the battle starts, and then it is the sandbox, right? Like, there's so many forces on your side, on the enemy side, maybe a third party. There's something interesting about the battle that's going on, and then you can play it a number of times, and it can turn out very differently. And that can be a good and a bad thing. It can be really easy, and then suddenly incredibly hard, because that one squadron just got completely obliterated. Anyways, we rendezvous with the smugglers, who give us the coordinates for where the meetup and the transfer is going to take place. And that's where we jump to, the small asteroid field outside of a gas giant, where we find an old beat-up rust bucket of a freighter, and our dad brings in the GR-75 to begin the transfer to bring the Bacta on board.
Initiating cargo transfer now. This will take several minutes. Vasudra, we're having trouble with our pumps. Stand by. We're going to send a few technicians out to take a look. Fine. I guess we'll just sit tight for the moment.
So much for smooth operations.
How many technicians does it take to check out the pumps? Something fishy's going on.
The atmosphere in this particular mission is probably one of the best so far, as you're just kind of hanging out and waiting. You know something's up.
They're heading toward the Vasudra's engines! It's a double cross!
We are hating to disappoint you, but you are surrendering now.
Guess again, scumbag!
Enemy in range!
Aaron, you and I have the firepower to take on that gunship.
I'm under attack! Defensive fire's too intense. I gotta back off.
Which means you'll have to take
take out those so-called taxis.
What's your status, Dad? Those technicians are disabling the Vasudra's engines. Galen! Vasudra, come in! These smugglers are pulling a trick!
I just think they are hiding out the body right now.
Ravenna is making a run for it.
Be surprised? You'll have to muscle their cards.
There's a bandit on your tail!
The pressure fire is too intense. They gotta back off.
Primary target update. Their shields are up. Report on primary target. They have been destroyed.
Yes! I'm glad I'm not on board that.
Ace and MK handle themselves superbly under fire. You should let them take the Otano next time.
That is the last of the technicians.
Good work, kids. I knew I could count on you. Galen and I have sorted things out on this end. We've convinced the end run's captain to finish the transfer.
All right, the cargo transfer is complete. Let's go home.
What about the end run? You want to just let them go? You think we should space them or something? Well, after what they just pulled?
Yeah.
Sorry, boy. That's not a good way to do business. Besides, I agreed to spare them if they just gave us the Bacta. I'm very proud of how you all handled a tough situation. As long as we stick together, we can handle anything.
And that wraps up our mission to go find the Bacta, and we ended up getting it for free. I mean, except for threats on our lives, but hey, we made it back. If you want to jump in, all the links are in the description. Just follow the guide that is on the front page. It'll be the first post. It'll say what mods that they recommend, and that's the ones that I'm using for the most part. And it works great for how old this game is. You do need a joystick, though. That is an absolute necessity or the game won't open. And I am playing the Steam version. Seems to work out pretty well. All right, everybody. I'll see you in the next one.
How was that for a little excitement? That bunch of criminals were just using the Bacta supply as bait. If they'd captured us, we would have ended up dead or sold to slavers. But I knew I could count on my kids if we got into a tough situation. You made me proud. This experience should teach you we live in dangerous times. We must always be on guard against treachery. But that doesn't mean we shouldn't do what we think is right. It's okay to take risks, as long as you take adequate precautions, and the goal is worthwhile. I think helping the rebellion to overthrow the Empire is worthwhile, don't you? Get some rest. We'll be going out again soon to deliver the Bacta to the Alliance.